Hi, I'm Greg Tito with your guide to the week's hottest news. This is the Escapist News Wrap. This Monday, we learned Micheal Fassbender signed on to appear in the possible film adaptation of Assassin's Creed. Fassbender moved metal and ladies' hearts with his mind as Magneto in X-Men First Class, and most recently appeared as a single-minded android in Prometheus. We don't know what character he'll play, Altair, Ezio, Desmond, or even the new protagonist from Assassin's Creed, Connor, but hopefully attaching his name will help boot up the animus on the silver screen. A potential scandal erupted in the MMO Terra, in which guild leaders repeatedly kill their own members to farm political capital. In the game, the position of Vanarch has far-reaching powers, but leaders can manipulate the system by ordering lower-level guild members to die in PvP to gain points. The developer's game guide acknowledges, and maybe even encourages, dirty tactics like bribing to secure votes, but it's unclear whether the goal was to make the politics in Arboria as shady as Chicago. What would you pay for every single game released by Nintendo and Sega in the first 20 years of video game history? An eBay user recently purchased such a collection, more than 5,000 titles in all, for a cool $1.2 million. The seller spent years assembling the collection, promising that if the games were not factory sealed, they were at least in the best possible condition. There's no word if the purchaser will actually play all these games, or if they have the approximately 19 years of free time to do so. Even though Max Payne 3 was a critical success, Rockstar closed the Vancouver studio which created it on Tuesday. The 35 employees are not completely screwed, thankfully. Rockstar extended an offer to relocate to the Toronto studio that made the Warriors adaptation. Moving the 2,000 miles from Vancouver to Toronto is no small feat, and may not be possible for all of the employees. Our thoughts go out to those affected by this studio closure. Somewhere, Max Payne lifts a glass to you for all your hard work. Can I get an ooh-yah? A new Kickstarter campaign debuted this week for an open-source console based on the Android operating system. The Ouya aims to make it easier for game makers to innovate with games played on your TV, not just on your iPad. The funding goal was $950,000, and it was surpassed in less than 24 hours. So far, Ouya's pitch has convinced more than 30,000 gamers to contribute more than $4 million, with 26 days still to go. Eat your heart out, Tim Schafer. There's a new Kickstarter king in town. Valve says Steam sales increase brand loyalty, not cheapen the IP. Last month, EA said its Origin service wouldn't resort to deep discounts like Steam does because they weren't, quote, target. Even though Origin did actually drop its prices significantly, Valve executives countered the argument by claiming that pre-orders and sales of full-price games have gone up since Steam instituted its sales. The sales create fans through impulse buys. So basically, Valve said to EA, you're wrong. Let's move on. League of Legends recently replaced World of Warcraft as the most heavily played PC game. According to statistics released by Xfire this week, gamers in North America and Europe played about 1.3 billion hours of League of Legends in the last 6 months. That's more than double the amount of time spent playing World of Warcraft in that same time period. Minecraft comes in a distant third place with 370 million hours building the replica of the Great Wall of China using only obsidian blocks. Or maybe that was just me. Finally, a diligent fan dug up patent documents filed by Microsoft, which indicate that the Xbox 720 might have scalable hardware specs. The leaked designs from 2010 also mention such a feature, but an actual US patent published last month points to the ability to swap out and upgrade CPU chips and graphics cards, similar to how PCs work now. It's easy to dismiss these rumblings as fake, but when the chief hardware architect for Microsoft puts his name at the top of an official patent application, the credibility factor starts to rise. That's your news wrap for this week. Stay tuned to escapistmagazine.com for all the latest gaming news.